Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class we will be dealing with all the four editorials of the Hindu dated the 12th of May. Now, like we have changed the pattern to do this decode classes, first of all we will be learning about what is the theme of all these editorials. So basically what we have is the four editorials. First of all, we have the lead editorial, and then we have the sub lead editorial, and then we have the corner top editorial, and then we have the corner bottom editorial. So we have these four editorials. Now, as far as the lead editorial is concerned, this editorial deals with augmented reality, and along with augmented reality, the author has compared this augmented reality with the religion. Augmented reality with religion. So this is the theme of this editorial. Now, from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 4. So this is important from GS paper 4 point of view. First of all, we need to learn about what is meant by augmented reality and how we can compare this augmented reality with religion. Now, before we understand this augmented reality and its comparison with religion, we must know about the physical world. Now, when it comes to the physical world, that the physical body we possess, according to the author, we are actually not satisfied with what capacities and capabilities this physical body offers. Ye jo hamara body hai, ye hame zyada capacity and capability offer nahi karta hai, jo hum karna chahte hain. And this is the reason why the scientists, and specifically Mark Zuckerberg, the founder of Facebook, he is trying to promote the idea of augmented reality. Now, augmented reality means reality at a higher scale, whereby your mind will be commanding how the machines would be carrying out its functions. Aapka dimag signal dega machines ko ki wo kis tarah kaam kare. You will be able to control the machines by your mind. So it is nothing but a kind of connectivity between neuroscience and electronics. So what we are trying to promote by this augmented reality is humans' access to the higher levels of technology, whereby one will be moving beyond this physical world. So we are trying to create a new kind of interaction between man and the machine. So hamara intention kya hai augmented reality se? Augmented reality se hum apne physical world ko chhod ke ek alag tarah ka world create karne ki koshish kar rahe hain. And religion jo hai, religion bhi yehi cheez karta hai. Religion also promotes that we should try to transcend the physical world. जो हमारा फिजिकल वर्ल्ड है, हम उसको छोड़ के एक मेटाफिजिकल वर्ल्ड की ओर मूव करें. दिस इज व्हाट इज प्रमोटेड बाय रिलीजन. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑथर, दिस आइडिया ऑफ ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी, इट विल बी इजी टू प्रमोट लाइक द आइडिया ऑफ रिलीजन, बिकॉज दिस रिलीजन ऑल्सो प्रमोट्स दैट वी विल बी फाइंडिंग सम काइंड ऑफ सोलेस, सम काइंड ऑफ पीस. हमें कुछ ना कुछ सुख मिलेगा अगर हम रिलीजन को बहुत अच्छे ढंग से प्रैक्टिस करेंगे. और ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी भी हमें वही चीज प्रमोट करने को कह रही है. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द थीम ऑफ दिस ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी एंड रिलीजन, द लीड एडिटोरियल. एंड दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एथिक्स जनरल स्टडीज मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन पेपर 4 पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. नाउ अनदर क्वेश्चन जो इसके साथ एसोसिएटेड आपको पूछा जा सकता है, दैट इज आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. Artificial intelligence and human ethics. Artificial intelligence plus human ethics. Now this is again that is very, very important.
So this is a question that can be asked in general studies mains examination paper 4. And when will you be writing this answer in your mains examination? So you must not forget to mention about this augmented reality and religion, because this again is very important. Then you have this sub-editorial. The sub-editorial is on generic drugs. Generic drugs. Now, before we understand this concept of generic drugs, it is important to understand what is meant by patents, and it is also important to understand the theme of why India wants generic drugs to be promoted. Now, like India is a poor country, there exists heightened levels of inequality in India. The poor people, they're not able to afford health services. Now, as per last year's economic survey, you have this economic survey figure which mentions that in India, the health cost is borne out of one's own pocket. So what it means? It means the government is spending less. So how much the government spends? It is just about 1.4 to 1.5% of GDP. So this much of amount is spent on the health services in India. So in such a conditions, the people, they cannot afford to buy expensive drugs. Now, why drugs are expensive? Now again, this is very important. Why drugs are expensive? एक्सपेंसिव ड्रग्स इतने महंगे क्यों होते हैं जो भी दवाइयां हैं उनका रेट इतना ज्यादा क्यों है गरीब लोग उसको क्यों अफोर्ड नहीं कर पाते नाउ ड्रग्स दे आर एक्सपेंसिव द बेसिक रीजन फॉर दैट इज दैट इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ आरएनडी टू प्रमोट टू जनरेट टू डेवलप न्यू टाइप ऑफ ड्रग्स सो ड्रग डेवलपमेंट इज समथिंग दैट इज नॉट ईजी Something that is not cheap, it is very expensive affair. And because R&D involves a lot of expense, this is the reason why most of the drugs, they are expensive. But as far as patenting of drugs is concerned, there is a time limit attached with any therapeutical cure. So if you have any kind of therapeutic cure, there is a timeline attached to it. Now what it means? It means that you cannot be using a particular drug. A particular drug cannot be patented for a very long period of time. Uska patent kuch samay ke liye milta hai therapeutic drug ka. Uske baad, jo normal pharmaceutical companies hain, wo drug ko manufacture कर सकती हैं and when the normal companies will be manufacturing the drugs using the specific chemicals by which a particular drug will be created that will be the generic name of that particular drug so as per the Medical Council of India it has passed an order it has passed a diktat that the doctors they should be writing the generic name of the drugs in the capital ki kisi bhi drug ka apne kisi bhi medicine ka reference dena hai apne patient ko you must mention the capital name of the generic drug you must not be mentioning the name of a branded drug because jo branded drug hai wo generic mein bhi available hai generic mein wo cheap available hai and for a country like India like we are a welfare state Now, Indian constitution promotes this idea of welfareism and we are also a socialist country and because we are a socialist country and we are a welfare nation it is very important that the drugs should be offered to the poor to the people at a cheap price this is one of the fundamental duty of the state agar desh agar sarkar ye basic cheez nahi karke degi तो जो लेजिटिमेसी है गवर्नमेंट का जो स्टेट का इट विल गेट विदेड इट विल गेट इरोडेड सो इफ अ स्टेट वॉन्ट्स टू कीप इट्स लेजिटिमेसी इंटैक्ट इट मस्ट प्रमोट अ चीप
and good healthcare system. Cheap means just in terms of the money that it will be charging. Now, there are certain important things with respect to generic drugs. Now, in generic drugs, what we discuss is the issue of the multiple drug combinations. Multiple drug combinations. Now, why doctors, they are not able to mention these generic drugs? Because if we compare Indian health system with that of the foreign nations, in India, we have this phenomenon of multi-drug combinations. Now, if you want any kind of drug, suppose you want to have paracetamol. Now, paracetamol will come in combination with numerous other pharmaceutical chemicals and drugs. You will not be able to find pharmaceutical paracetamol alone, though paracetamol salt is easy to have from the medical store. But there are numerous other pharmaceutical drugs that are not available in single. So there is not a singular availability of that particular drug. They are actually available in combination. So multiple drug combination system, it is quite prevalent in India. Now, because it is prevalent in India, it really is a problem for the doctors to mention these generic drugs name while prescribing a particular cure to a patient. So if we really want to work on this generic drugs and promotion of the generic drugs, first of all, we need to do away with this MDC. And the author has also used, has talked about bioequivalence. This is another important thing. Now, when it comes to this bioequivalence, we will be discussing this bioequivalence in the Brainika current affair magazine that we'll be uploading on BrainyIAS.com. So this is what I was supposed to discuss under this theme of generic drugs in India, why they should be promoted in India, and what is a big hindrance why these drugs are not being promoted. So we also have an issue of bioequivalence. We'll be discussing this issue in Brainika. Now, this was about the sub-lead editorial. We have already discussed the lead editorial. Now, we'll be discussing the top corner editorial. Now, this editorial is not important from mains or prelims examination point of view. This relates to the removal of the FBI director by Donald Trump. His name was Mr. Comey. So, you just need to know about this. Now, the bottom one, it relates to TB. Now, this is again a very important editorial with respect to the health issue. Now, first of all, we need to understand why this disease of TB is important to understand and why there is a prevalence of TB in the Indian subcontinent or in the countries like South Africa or in the continent of Africa. Why there is mass prevalence of TB itna zyada kyun hota hai? Now, in order to understand this, we need to know that India basically lies in the subtropical zone. Because India lies in the subtropical zone, there is a lot of humidity, there is a lot of heat, there is prevalence of high temperature in the Indian subcontinent, and the bacteria, it actually sustains itself under such conditions, under tropical conditions. So this is again important thing. So this is one of the reasons why there is a lot of prevalence of the TB in India. But in this, we are not only talking about TB, but we are also talking about multi-drug resistant TB. Multi-drug resistant TB or extensively drug resistant TB. So we have these two new things attached with this concept of TB. So now India is not only suffering from this menace of TB, but we are also suffering from this menace of multi-drug resistant TB and extensively drug resistant TB. Now, because of the misuse of the tubercular drugs, the bacterial drugs, antibacterial drugs, this bacteria, it has become very resistant. Resistant to the first line drugs of the TB, the second line drugs of the TB, and the third line drugs of the TB. And this is the reason why India is witnessing this multi-drug resistant TB. जो बैक्टीरिया है वो बहुत ज्यादा रेजिस्टेंट हो गया है. अब दवाई से बैक्टीरिया मरता नहीं है. सो इफ वी रियली वॉन्ट टू टेक केयर ऑफ दिस टीबी, मल्टी ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट एंड एक्सटेंसिवली ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट टीबी, एंड लाइक एज फार एज इंडियाज हेल्थ पॉलिसी इज कंसर्न, इट इज द एम ऑफ द हेल्थ पॉलिसी टू इरेडिकेट दिस टीबी डिजीज बाय 2025. एंड इफ वी रियली वॉन्ट टू इरेडिकेट दिस डिजीज बाय 2025, we really need to work on a strategy of how to tame this TB. Abhi doctors kisi bhi bimari ke liye ab doctor ke paas jaate ho, to doctor aapko TB ka antibacterial medicine aapko refer kar deta hai. Ab itne zyada aadmi ek saal mein itna zyada antibacterial medicine itni zyada kha leta hai ki jo bacteria hai wo bahut zyada resistant ho gaya hai. This is only one thing. And jo एक इंपॉर्टेंट इंसाइट है इस एरिया के बारे में, दैट हैज बीन गिवन बाय दिस मेडिकल जर्नल कॉल्ड एज लैंसेट. नाउ एज पर लैंसेट, इन इंडिया दिस मल्टी ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट टीबी और एक्सटेंसिवली ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट टीबी, इट विल बी प्रमोटेड और इट विल बी एनहांसिंग इट्स मेनासिबिलिटी, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ द मिसयूज ऑफ दिस ड्रग्स, but because of the less treatment of the patients, and it will be passed from those patients to the healthy population. Hame un logon se bhi ab TB ho sakta hai, multi drug resistant TB, jin logon ko already ye multi drug resistant TB ho rakha hai. It is not necessary ki maine bahut zyada antibacterial medicines khayi aur mere andar ka bacteria resistant ho gaya, aisa nahi hai. वैसा बैक्टीरिया हमारी बॉडी के अंदर भी एंटर कर सकता है किसी और से जिसको ऑलरेडी ये टीबी हो रखा है. सो दिस वाज ऑल फॉर द डे. यू कैन सब्सक्राइब टू दिस चैनल. नेम ऑफ द चैनल इज ब्रेनी आईएएस. यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी एट 8459400000 इन केस इंटरेस्टेड इन बाइंग द एंटायर सिविल सर्विसेज क्लासेस. और यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन अवर ऑफलाइन क्लासेस इन चंडीगढ़. वी हैव अकेडमी ब्रेनी आईएएस अकेडमी इन सेक्टर 24 इन चंडीगढ़. सो दिस वाज ऑल फॉर द डे. बाय बाय, टेक केयर, हैव अ नाइस नाइस डे.